If you are tired of getting the same show recommendations every time you ask someone for a new show to watch, you are not alone. So in this video, we are talking about the 10 best undervalued series to binge watch now in 2021. These nominations are based solely on our personal preferences for entertainment value. Before we begin, be sure to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more movie/TV show recommendation countdowns and theories. Ginny and Georgia, Netflix. Calling Ginny and Georgia an undervalued show is a bit of a stretch, seeing as how it is now the longest number one show in the Netflix top 10 rankings, overtaking the Tiger King's previous record. The reason we consider it undervalued is due to the fact that many fans have judged this show by its cover, which sort of gives off Gilmore Girls vibes. This show is anything but that, as it follows Georgia, a single mother of two played by Brianne Howie, who moves back to the town she grew up in after her husband passed away from a sudden heart attack. However, like her daughter, Ginny continuously insinuates there's always something more to Georgia than what we see on the surface.
You're the worst mom in the world.
Hey, you do not talk to your mother like that. She deserves your respect.
Yeah, respect me, you little shit. I hate you. I hate you more.
Some may be put off by the teenage drama that is mixed in with the show, but if you can get past that, we guarantee you that watching Georgia pull off her elaborate schemes will make it all worthwhile. While season 2 has yet to be confirmed, we believe it's only a matter of time before it does, especially since they left us on such a major cliffhanger at the end of season 1. Servant, Apple TV. Anything from the mind of M. Night Shyamalan is bound to have some sort of psychological twist to it, but in our opinion, very few of his works can match up to The Servant. After the tragic loss of their infant Jericho, Dorothy and Sean Turner turn to a rebirth doll, which is a realistic and, in our opinion, creepy-looking doll used to help mothers cope with the loss of their baby. While the doll may have been used with good intentions to help Dorothy, it quickly begins to go downhill when they hire a strange nanny named Leanne to watch over the baby. Yes, we said baby, not doll. The show does an amazing job of highlighting not only how trauma can drastically affect a person's life, but also just how far people are willing to go to continue living in their own reality. Throughout the show, especially in season 2, while watching Dorothy slowly begin to have a complete mental breakdown, you will realize everything that transpires could have been avoided if only someone would have just told her the truth. Breeders, FX and Hulu. Breeders may just be the most relatable show on this entire list, as it shows parents Paul and Allie deal with the real-life difficulties of raising two children. We have all seen shows where the parents yell at their children in the nicest way possible, which we all know is not realistic at all. Whether you are a parent or not, we all remember our parents yelling at us when we were little, and it wouldn't sound staged like it did on TV. Well, Breeders manages to change all that. A dark comedy that shows correctly just how frustrating parenting is by loving your children, but at the same time wanting to pull a wrestling move on them every once in a while.
I would die for those kids, Ali, but often I also want to kill them.
Yeah, it's a conundrum, isn't it?
If you are a parent, you will laugh seeing your frustrations and perhaps actions be played out on television. And if you aren't a parent, you may just get insight into why your parents parented you the way they did. The 12, Netflix. The 12 follows the lives of some of the jurors on a high-profile murder trial in Belgium. The case involves a woman, Fry, who is accused of killing not only her best friend years ago, but her 4-year-old daughter as well. The show is so well written that while the main focus is the murder trial, it also shines a light on other difficult topics such as the evolution of domestic violence in a relationship. What will really draw you into this show will not just be the whodunit aspect of the trial. Instead, it'll be the actual court proceedings. While we all enjoy seeing a lawyer make an incompetent detective look stupid on the stand in any country, it's when the jurors go back to deliberate that the show hits its peak with showing just how difficult it is to be in a deliberation like that. If you are familiar with one of the greatest movies, 12 Angry Men, let us know in the comments if this show reminded you of it. Oh, and not to mention how they revealed who the actual killer was.
Oh my God!
Caliphate, Netflix. The Swedish hit on Netflix, Caliphate, shows the process of radicalization through the recruitment of new members or showing the end result after joining a terrorist organization. The story follows Pervin, a mother who is willing to do anything to escape ISIS, such as give up information on an upcoming terrorist attack in Sweden, and Suleika, a teenage girl on the verge of becoming radicalized. This was an eye-opening experience, not only to get a glimpse inside the life of the terrorist group back in Syria, but the most chilling part is seeing the process of how young men and women become radicalized. Pervin may just be one of the bravest characters we have seen in recent times, especially knowing the deadly consequences she would face if she were to get caught. There are so many aspects to this show that will draw a lot of discussion, but none more so than choosing between self-preservation or being someone's hero. We will give a warning that when you reach the finale, it will be difficult to watch. Not because of the quality, but rather because of the tragic situations the characters are placed in. Behind Her Eyes, Netflix. Behind Her Eyes may just rank up there with The Haunting of Hill House in terms of the most shocking endings of any Netflix show. It follows single mother Louise, who begins an affair with her boss David, while also starting a friendship with David's wife Adele, who deals with mental illness. Talk about a messy love triangle. This is anything but your regular show that deals with cheating, as it also incorporates topics such as astral projection. While the premise of the show may not be that believable to some, it does bring up the discussion of whether you would do something so unethical if you could get away with it. We don't want to spoil the season 1 finale, so we'll leave you with this. When watching this show, you have to think way outside the box to guess the ending. No word yet on a season 2, but we find it hard to believe that Netflix won't pick it up, especially after that cliffhanger at the end. Imposters, Netflix. We've all heard the saying, be careful who you marry. Well, Imposters is a prime example of that. It stars Inbar Lavi as Maddie, a con artist who does the whole marry people for their money, take it all, and then disappear act, leaving them used, broke, and depressed. That was until three of her former marks team up and decide to try to beat her at her own game by exposing her to her next husband. What follows is some of the funniest dark comedy that we have seen watching three rookies try to beat a pro at her own game.
We just have to find one thing that rings true for all of us, all right?
A story about a dog.
A Bichon.
Yeah, and she really loved it. But this one time,
it ran out of the house.
And into the snow.
But the dog was all white.
So they couldn't find it. You guys!
Write it down.
She had a dog.
It may have been canceled after a second season, but fans of the show will forever be hoping Netflix does a third season. Warning label on this one. If you have underlying trust issues towards your partner, we suggest you stay away from this one because it won't help the situation. Snowpiercer, TNT. We have to give credit to TNT for taking Bong Joon-ho's film of the same name, which starred Chris Evans, and creating a new and well-planned story from it. The TV show adaptation keeps the same premise of the last of humanity surviving another ice age on a massive train, but still having to deal with classism. Unlike the movie, which was very fast-paced, the show is able to shine a light on the daily struggles of all the passengers on the train. The first season shows the difficulties of Andre leading a coup and taking over the train. However, showing the difficulties of holding on to power in the second season is what is most enjoyable, especially with the return of Wilford. If there is one thing that both the movie and show make very clear, it's that living on a train for the rest of your life looks like a living hell. Clarice, CBS. You know you are famous when you are known just by your first name. Just like when we say LeBron, Serena, or
Clarice.
Have you ever wondered exactly what happened to FBI agent Clarice Starling after the Silence of the Lambs? Well, neither did we. That was until we gave the first episode of the new show a shot. We were not disappointed after seeing Clarice have to deal with the psychological effects of interacting with not only Hannibal Lecter, but also Buffalo Bill, all while investigating other murder cases. If that weren't bad enough, she still has to manage to deal with working in a male-dominated workplace that shows open resentment towards her and her early success. Aside from that, we are able to get a better understanding of how her challenging childhood made up the complex psychological makeup that allows her to catch murderers. It's also sort of thrilling just watching and waiting for that moment where we see Clarice finally mentally snap. Alice in Borderland, Netflix. Based on the popular manga, the Alice in Borderland live-action adaptation has thankfully broken the curse of terrible live-action manga shows.
I'm not gonna give the note to you or anybody else, and if you f*** with me again, I'm gonna put your name in it.
You could try.
It follows Arisu, an obsessed gamer who, along with his friends, find themselves in an emptied-out Japan, where they must compete in deadly games that involve mental and physical torture just to survive. The storyline may be a little out there, but think of it as The Purge if The Purge was in a game format. You will feel your adrenaline pumping as you watch Arisu and his friends try to complete these deadly games without becoming casualties or turning on each other. After the shocking reveal in the season 1 finale, we can expect the games to become even deadlier in season 2. Down in the comments, let us know what show you believe needs more recognition. If you enjoyed this video, check out some of our other recommendation countdown videos and theories. See you in the next video.